JSON is a data interchangeable format. It stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It is probably one of the most popular formats to be used for exchanging information between browsers and servers. Therefore, they contain ton of useful information. Today, we are going to make our data analysis with JSON way easier by integrating with Python. So keep watching. Let's see how a JSON looks. This is the basic representation of a JSON data. You can see values are separated by keys and values, which are separated by colons. Now, on first look, you might think this looks like a Python dictionary, right? However, even if it does look like a Python dictionary, there are differences between a dictionary and JSON. Let's go ahead and see what the differences are. Dictionary is basically a Python data type. However, JSON is a data format. To store dictionary into a file or send it over a network connection, you need to turn the dictionary into a series of bytes. This is called serialization. JSON is basically one set of rule to convert data structure to series of bytes and vice versa. It's only when you convert that data structure to series of bytes, then only you can send it over to different servers as a request and get back some response. Once you get back the response in bytes, then you convert those bytes to readable format in your browser, and that is called deserialization. The first thing that we are going to learn today is reading JSON data. So to read JSON data, let's first go ahead and get some JSON data, right? So now we'll go to our trusty Quandl.com for some data on finance. So we'll use the free data. Doesn't matter which data, it's just important that we all use the same kind of data so it is clear what we are reading. I will go to Wiki Continuous Features. It's my favorite data set. And then let's just choose the first data set, right? Now, when you click on the first data set, Minneapolis, HRWI, HardRed, Wheat Features, in the download format, instead of clicking on CSV, last time while reading CSV file, we clicked on CSV. Today we'll click on JSON. When you click on JSON, this is the kind of data set that you're going to get, right? So what we'll do is we'll copy this whole thing and then I'll come back to my script editor and I'm going to create a new file here and I'll call it test.json, right? And I'm going to copy paste everything here basically. So everything seems to be copied to one line. Okay. So now, this is the JSON format of the data set. Yeah. So now we are going to read JSON data. Now the easiest way to read JSON data is by importing the JSON module from Python. So I can say import JSON and then we are going to use the JSON.load built-in function in Python to read the data. So let's go ahead and see how it works. So I can say variable data equal to JSON.load and then within load, I have to open the JSON file and then read it, right? So I can say open and the name of the JSON file, the name of the JSON file is test.json. And let's go ahead and print this. Now if I run this, so basically this is how Python is reading the JSON file using the JSON function. Now let's go ahead and print out the type of this data. So if I print the type of this data, Python is going to return us dict. So basically we read the JSON file using the JSON library. JSON.load, the load built-in function, you are going to use it only for reading JSON files, okay? Not for reading strings. Remember, for reading strings, we are going to look at it in the next segment. For reading strings, we are going to use JSON.loads. So there is an extra S, and that extra S is basically for string. So to read a JSON file that you can open with an open built-in function, we are going to use JSON.load. And this, after we load it, load the JSON file and read it, Python is going to read it as a dictionary. But this is kind of stupid, right? Like, why are we copying the whole text from browser, creating a file, saving those data to our file and then reading it? I mean, this is not only prone to errors, a lot of human errors, but it's kind of stupid and hectic, right? Usually, JSON is used for transferring data or information between browsers and servers. So we don't actually need to save the JSON data to a file and read it. That's where we are going to use the request library to directly read JSON from Quandl.com, Quandl API, and we'll see how it works. So instead of going to Quandl, downloading JSON, copying it and saving it to a file and then opening it, we are directly going to use import requests. Request is a library for reading data directly from API, for getting data, posting data, and this basically allows inter-API functioning. We are going to learn a lot about the request library in the future. But for now, let me show you how you can read JSON data directly from the Quandl API. So here, instead of downloading Quandl JSON, here you can see export data. So basically, if you want to read the JSON file directly from the API, go ahead and click on this JSON. And here you will see, use this API call to get data in JSON format using your selected parameters. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to copy this entire URL. Now, if you're a little confused, don't worry, we are going to cover requests in the next segment very soon. So now I just want to show you what is the, how JSON is majorly used, how actually in real life, in your professional life, you are going to read JSON. So here, instead of saying data json.load, I'm going to first declare a variable called request, and I'll say request is equal to requests.get. And then inside dot get function or method within double quotes, I'm gonna paste the entire URL that we got from the Quandl API basically. Yeah. So now once the request is there, I'm gonna read. So what the get method is going to do, it is going to get all the information that is there in the API using this URL. Once we get the request, I'm gonna say request underscore text equal to request dot text. So basically this is going to read all the information as a text format, as a string format. So now, like we discussed earlier, to read JSON directly from string, we are going to use the JSON dot loads. Instead of load, we are going to add an S to the method and we are going to use that parameter. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'll say data is equal to JSON dot loads, and then inside loads I'm gonna pass in request underscore text, and let's then go ahead and print the data. So if I run this, you can see we are getting the same data set that we first copied from Quandl, then put it in our JSON file and then we read it. We are basically going to get the same data set. Go ahead, compare yourself, you will know that I'm telling the truth. So this is basically the major use of JSON. We can directly read JSON from any browser that has an API and allows people to, you know, scrape data from their API. We can basically use JSON in such a beautiful way. And then now this is a dictionary, right? So basically if I do a type here and I run this, this is basically a dictionary. So now we know how to manipulate dictionaries, how to read dictionaries and change them, update them. So now you can do anything you want using this JSON library from Python. So we saw how we can read JSON data from APIs or from a file and convert it to readable format on our Python script, right? That process is basically called deserialization. Let's see how the opposite of deserialization or serialization works. So that means basically you convert a data type to bytes, to strings of bytes, which is using the JSON format, the data interchangeable format. And we'll do that using the JSON library in Python, right? Now, as we saw the concept of loading with JSON, so if you are loading from a JSON file, you are going to use JSON.load. If you are loading from a string which is in JSON format, you are going to use JSON.loads. Similarly, for writing data to a file, to a JSON file, we are going to use JSON.dump. We are going to dump all the data to a JSON file using JSON.dump. However, if you want to dump all the data to a string basically, and we want to keep using the JSON format as a string in our script for our next purpose, then we are going to use JSON.dumps. These concepts, the loading and dumping concepts, are basically similar. So it will help you remember the method that you're going to use. So here you can see, I already have the data here that we read from the Quandl API. And this basically contains a dictionary, right? We check the type and it is a dictionary. Now I want to convert it into a JSON format, or basically strings of bytes. And I'm going to do that, and I want to store it as a string variable. So for that, I'm going to use JSON.dumps. So here I can say data underscore serialized equal to JSON.dumps. And then I'm going to pass in the data variable that we have got, which contains the dictionary. And then we are going to print out data underscore serialized. So if I run this, so you can see here, this is basically the serialized data. Now, if I print type data here, and if I print type data deserialized here, you can basically see the difference what I'm talking about. So if I run this again, you see the first is a type dictionary. The second is a type string. So we have converted the dictionary to strings of bytes, right? So this is basically dumping data to JSON format in a string variable. However, we would rather dump this data to a JSON file, right? Because then we can use that file to read and write again whenever we want, instead of storing it here, because that's lots of data and we are storing all that data into the variable. So here, for that purpose, if you want to load the data as JSON to a file, then we are going to use JSON.dump. Instead of S, we are going to remove this S basically. Right, like this. So let me first remove this print statement. And so here I can say data underscore serialize is equal to JSON.dump data. And then we have to give a file name, right? So here I can say open. And then I'm going to pass in the file name where I want to drop all the data. I'll say data.json. And I'm going to open this file name in writable format. Okay. So we should be able to write to that JSON file. Now, if I run this. So process finished with exit code 0. That means it ran successfully. And here you can see there's a data.json file. And now we have all the data that we read from the Quandl API inside our data.json. Go ahead, do this experiment, try to compare the data. It's going to be the same. So this is basically you how you handle JSON files with Python. This might seem at this moment, you may not see the benefit of doing this. But imagine you are working with data engineering and you have to read thousands and thousands of JSON files. You can basically read all of them using a for loop, copy all of them to one JSON file, do all sorts of data analysis with the JSON files. So basically this is very helpful. Let's go ahead and talk about some keyword arguments that we can use with JSON.dump. Basically when we are dumping JSON data to a JSON file, we can use some keyword arguments to make our data look better, or the visualization, we can make it better using some keyword arguments. So the first keyword argument that we are going to learn is indent. Before that, let's just go ahead and look at the data. Now this is the data, right? This is the JSON data that we have in data.json and we got in our last segment. But if you look at this, it doesn't look that readable. I mean, it doesn't look that pretty, you know, it will be very difficult for us to understand, okay, what is happening, where the dictionary is starting, where the curly brackets are starting, where is it ending. So for that purpose, to make it more readable, we can use a keyword called as indent. Let's go ahead and check out what this indent function does. So if you use this indent keyword argument, if I open this again, you can see now our data is in a very nice readable format, you know. So this basically makes the data more visual and more readable, and it is very easier to handle such data now because we know, okay, what we are dealing with. The next keyword argument that I'm going to show you is basically called as separators. Now, remember one caveat before I show you separators. Ideally, you should not use separators at all. Or if you use separators, be careful while you use separators, because you can use separators to make changes to your data, but then the JSON file may not recognize the changes. Even if the changes are applied, you will see errors in your JSON file. However, it is still important, I believe that you should know all the pros and cons of using different keyword arguments. This is just going to make you a better programmer, you know. So what is separators keyword argument? So basically, like we saw in dictionary and in JSON, the key value pairs are separated by a colon, right? And the key value pairs themselves, like all the key value pairs, are separated by a comma, right? So using separators, basically we can change that. Separators takes in a tuple as an argument. Inside the tuple, the first index is basically going to be that symbol or that separator that is going to separate all the key value pairs. Usually it is a comma, but I can change it to something like, let's say, you know, semicolon, right? I can change it to semicolon, and the first index key value pairs are separated by colon. I can change it to, let's say, a hyphen, you know. Now let's go ahead and run this data. Now if I open data.json, you will see the colon has been replaced by dash, and if we the commas have been replaced by semicolon. So this is basically what the separator function does. However, if you see this, it says JSON standard allows only one top value level. So basically this is not a proper JSON supported file. So this is something you will have problems with if you use the separator. So be careful how you're going to use the JSON separator keyword argument, and be aware that sometimes if this issue is happening, maybe because in the code we have something with the separators that is causing this problem. So this is a very useful information that I believe you should have. So guys, that's all for handling JSON data with Python. Now if you become a Python developer or a data engineer, you will realize this is a trick that would be very useful to you while solving your problems. So make sure you go through the tutorial very well. Also, in the next tutorial, we are going to study about request library, basically the entire concept of, you know, reading data from different APIs, doing authentication and everything. So in that context also, we are going to see a lot of practical examples by querying the Google Analytics API, some more Quandl data, and a lot of things where you will see the actual application of JSON. Thank you guys. I'll see you in the next tutorial.